a six-man elimination match.
And we were told it is tag rules, not tornado rules. So we'll see if that's the case.
And we have a man making his debut in PPW. He's been around a few years, but he's making his debut here in PPW.
Longtime tag partner of Virgil Flynn.
And he's a guy who, like Flynn, he can get up into the air a little bit. He can stay on the mat with a couple people. He's got a good all-around game. But he looks to make himself known here at PPW with this match. Been waiting for this guy.
But you know, there's no turning back now. This is what makes me. This is what I am, man.
Eric, it's one of your favorites.
I'm a big fan of Rick Luxury. Men have accomplished as much in the Northern California pro wrestling scene as Rick Luxury has accomplished. This guy has done it all.
Rick Luxury, as we said, one of the more decorated wrestlers here in Northern California.
Also making his Phoenix pro wrestling debut.
And here's a guy that I know that we saw in the first go around of PPW. Now, Jekyll's teamed with his normal partner, Jinx, to take on Cold Cold World.
And they got the win.
And they got the win. And Jekyll's looked very impressive when we saw him a couple weeks back, the tournament committee, and was in attendance.
In attendance at the APW's 313 show. And Jekyll's was arguably the standout performer in his six-man. And now, just last weekend, competed in the opening round of the King of the Indies tournament.
And here's someone that we also saw at the first PPW show. This guy oozes something.
He oozes a lot of things. This guy is a real sleaze, and he really does not care that that's how he's perceived. He's slimy.
You can't do that to the kids in the audience. Come on, Truex.
Look at how uneasy he makes some of the other guys. I don't know if you saw Luxury and Jekyll's looking
him
down.
Jekyll's always sits like that, though.
Right.
Oh, here we go. And look who's with Big Ben Johnson.
We got Caesar coming out with Big Ben Johnson.
So Caesar's out here with Big Ben Johnson. You don't have to tell us, man.
The championship committee decided up there. Take it up with them.
Caesar, one of the more flamboyant managers of wrestlers here in the area. We saw him with Cool Cool World, and now he's got himself a new protege.
Recruited Big Ben.
And we have a sixth man that was added to this match before
tonight. This was a surprise late addition, and as you'll see, this guy really has something to prove.
Rick Luxury having his time with the fan. And look at this man, Harry Henderson.
Henderson. Now, I'm not sure if you've noticed one of the disadvantages that Harry has, but he told us he likes to be called hip-hoppin' Harry, whether that refers to his love of hip-hop music.
Rick, we can't. That's our job.
Literally the only thing we're here to do.
We apologize. Oh, wait a minute. He wants it back.
If you people start that Hey Rick chant, I'm leaving.
Well, that's just not, that's not, that's. Oh, wow. Okay.
He's
well,
done.
Rick Luxury.
Back to a five-man elimination?
Rick Luxury's left, and we don't know what's going on. We were expecting a six-man elimination match. Last man standing is your winner. Tag rules. It's only two men in the ring at the same time.
And he's gone.
Yeah, we're trying. He wanted his music. I don't know if it was exit music, if it was re-entrance music. Oh, yeah.
There we go.
There
he goes. There we go.
He was fooling us.
Re-entry.
Okay.
Into the ring.
This is even extravagant for the man they call wrestling personified.
This is a bit much. I guess he didn't like being the second entrant. Wanted the final entrance.
So he gets two entrances because I guess he says so.
I mean, I guess nobody's asked before.
I'm
so
sure.
If you wanted it that badly, then yeah, I guess.
So you can see in this setup, there'll be two men in the ring at once. You can tag in whoever you want. But the idea. Harry Henderson getting the crowd behind him.
Making his debut and already getting the fans on his side. Admittedly, difficult to find reasons to root against a man with one leg.
But I'll tell you what, he looks like he's ready to go as him and Big Ben Johnson. Okay, come on, Ben. That's just wrong.
I like Harry. Look at Harry getting low, going in for it.
They lock up in the middle, so. The two largest combatants in the ring right now going at each other. We saw Big Ben, as we said earlier, at the first PPW show. He ended up facing the boogeyman Joe DeSole. And you can see Henderson, single
nice
leg takedown.
Ankle
down.
Pick there
yeah.
from Harry.
That's a those moves, man, those are leverage moves. And in this game, when you are able to find one of those pressure points, and the ankle is one of those big pressure points, you get it to twist a certain way, you have complete control over the body, and that's what Henderson did there. Nice move. But Ben is right back on top of him.
What do you suppose he does with the other shoes when he buys a pair?
I would not know. I've never been in that situation where I've only needed one shoe. And oh, there's Caesar.
Caesar, that's the benefit of having a manager like that on your side. You Ben lost in his debut here at PPW, comes back with Caesar, and already getting an easy advantage.
I'll tell you what, you know, Ben, we talked about it. He basically told us all he wants to do is go out there, be mean, and beat down whoever's across from him. That's what he told us. And now he's going to have to do that, and a drop kick to the knee, and now Henderson with a DDT. Nicely done by hip-hop Harry Henderson in a two count. And look at Luxury right now. Oh, a tag. Now, this is what's interesting about this match is that normally, if it were a situation where the first man gets the pin, you don't want to come out of the match.
No.
But if you feel like you need to come out, of course someone wouldn't mind getting in.
Right. Any of these guys would want to be tagged in at any time. But it's also very smart to stay on the apron. It is an elimination match.
Luxury and Jekylls have definitely seen each other a lot. And Henderson, who took Luxury down, is going to give Jekylls a shot. And we talked about it. King of Indies, he looked very good at the APW show about a month ago. He got a victory here. At Phoenix Pro Wrestling, Jekylls has been looking good. and Luxury trying to elbow his way out. Oh, nice move by Jekylls to flip over. What a right hand.
Big right hand.
Oh, we heard that.
And not many guys work California more than Jekylls. He goes all up and down the state.
Well, nice move. A running blockbuster. And a senton. Jekylls looking good. And yeah, the crowd likes it. I tell you what, Jekylls has been really impressing me.
He's been at this a long time. But over the last 6 months in particular, some of the best stuff probably of his whole career.
Yeah, he's really been stepping up his game. And I think it was all in anticipation of that King of Indies weekend, which he was a part of.
It's almost as if once he got announced for being in King of the Indies, it just lit a fire under him. It was what he needed to take him to the next stage of his career.
Big boot there by Jekylls, and now all the puppet show. We've seen this before. Now into the back suplex. Crowd liking Jekylls tonight, and he's gonna give Daniel Force a shot. You said the longtime tag team partner of one Virgil Flynn, him and Rick Luxury have had their battles.
Yeah. Yeah, Torch has been started with APW 2008, 2009. Missed a lot of time with a broken leg from taking a drop kick
in the corner. Yeah, he got trapped up on the bottom rope.
And that always the opportunity is Truex tags in right after Torch gets folded in half with a German.
And a nice momentum move there by Luxury. And Forrest taking a chop. And, well, that's not good. Holding the arms there, choking him with the boot. Forrest with nowhere to go.
It's a smart move for Rick Luxury to take a bath, bail to the apron after hitting that German. You don't get any points for eliminating more guys in a match.
That's
let other guys do your work for you. Save yourself up for when there's less men.
Big back elbow by Truex, a cover, and only a one count. Our first cover of this six-man elimination, our main event here at the Pro PW Road to the Championship. And Force was looking for a Hurricane Rana there, but Truex catches him. Force with a backflip out, and now a spinning back kick. Tags Henderson and a stunner. Oh, man, Henderson got the tag. Force was going for the cover and realized too late that he tagged him. So here's Henderson, senton of his own. One, two, and Truex gets the shoulder up. Yo, a knee to the stomach and Henderson down. Truex, oh, just blatant choke there. There's nothing fancy about that.
Mm-mm.
Truex trying to make Henderson the first elimination in this six-man match. Oh, he's looking for maybe a choke slam. Got him by the throat. Oh, no, now Henderson's got him by
the
throat.
Both men got each other by the throat.
Oh, here comes Johnson. Choke slams his move. Oh, he's got a double goozle. Oh, now Truex has the double goozle.
All of the chokes.
Oh, a triple choke slam. Oh, but Jekylls is there. They don't see him. Oh, he wants a double choke slam of his own. There it is. And Jekylls has to be very happy with how this has turned out for him. He's going to get a cover, two count. Oh, he's going to try and cover everyone. And right now, Sparky Bauer just, you know, counting whatever covers he can. He needs to know who the legal man is.
I have completely lost track of the legal man.
There's Luxury. One, two, and only a two count.
Is it still Truex and Harry?
I thought that was the case, but, well, it's broken down. Here comes Jekylls over the top!
There we go. I asked Sparky Ballard pre-match if it was tornado rules or tag rules. He says it doesn't matter. Either way, it's probably going to break down.
And, well, what do you know?
How about that?
Jekylls with a beautiful dive. Oh, we've seen Force
Jekylls
fly.
Jekylls has done more flying in the last few months than I've ever seen.
Force! He clears the top
no
rope.
No hands. No hands. High jumping over the top rope.
No hands, no legs, no nothing. My goodness. Daniel Force with a hurdle. He might not be done. Everybody's down except for Force, who's kind of making his way alongside the apron.
Yeah, Daniel Torch is really, really opening eyes right now.
Torch is out of it, and it is back to Henderson and Truex, who are the legal men. So now we have a little bit of control. Oh, that, well, you don't need that. Ah, oh, that's just disgusting. Truex with the old one-hand special.
Likely some of that ooze that you mentioned earlier from Truex. Big overhand chops.
Henderson getting ready to come in. Oh, a cannonball! Oh my goodness. A corner cannonball by Harry Henderson. And now he might have Truex where he wants him. Wait a minute, he's ready to go up top. Jekylls is telling him to go get some. He's waiting for Truex to get up, and he does. Oh, he's looking for a drop kick, and Truex moved out of the way. Truex might be looking, and he does. That's his move. One, two, and Henderson is out.
Harry Henderson has been eliminated.
Jekylls is right in. He took his cue. No tag needed when a guy is eliminated.
Looking for the rolling elbow, and Truex ducks, and now he's ready for a backdrop. Suplex, nicely executed by Jekylls. And now he wants to go up top. Truex with that wrist clutch brain buster to take the first elimination fall, and now it's him and the evil jester Jekylls, and now the rolling elbow misses. Truex, his clothesline misses, and a German suplex by Jekylls.
I'm kind of surprised Truex himself hasn't tried to tag out.
Jekylls looking for the rolling elbow and hits him on top of the head. He's going to go for the cover. One, two, only a two count. Looks like he might have kind of spun himself dizzy a couple times there trying to hit that elbow.
I've seen that happen with Jekylls. He's a weird guy to pin down.
But Truex kicks Jekylls back. Truex with an elbow of his own. Gonna send him in. Ben Johnson got a tag. There's a rolling elbow. But Truex is not legal.
Jekylls didn't see the tag.
Jekylls is not legal. Truex is down too, and Ben Johnson's gonna steal one. Now Daniel Torch is coming in. And a big running elbow for Ben Johnson. Oh, he was looking to get a knee up, but Torch got him with a pump kick. But Johnson's back up with an elbow. Truex has to get out of there.
Luxury kick Truex out of the ring.
Oh, nice back elbow there. Very snug right under the chin by Johnson. Ready maybe a power bomb. Oh, it's saved, and a rolling elbow. Another tag in, returning the favor is Jekylls, and he's gonna get Johnson out of there. So Johnson with the blind tag on Jekylls seals Jekylls' pin, and then Jekylls does the same to Johnson.
We've talked about the risk of purposely tagging in to a match like this.
Oh man, there's a code breaker by Luxury. One, two, and three, and Luxury sent Jekylls home, and we're already down to our final two
wrestlers. We're already down to the last two guys, Daniel Torch and Rick Luxury.
The Busaiku knee kick, one, two, oh, almost got him as Daniel Torch almost stole one. That running knee kick that has become kind of a move that a lot of people have used. Looking for that stunner again, and gets it.
It's that springboard back stunner.
One, through, and only a two count is trying to call the match. And
a lot of guys Caesar getting booted out of here all at the same time.
Luxury with a beautiful pancake counter out of that tilt-a-whirl head scissors attempt.
And we knew this is exactly what Luxury wanted from the beginning. Let everybody else get out of there, and that's when he comes in. That's when he comes in to take advantage of the situation.
Luxury waiting. Oh, he went for the go to sleep, but it is Torch with an ace crusher and a super kick. A second one. Oh, but Luxury cuts back with one of his own.
I thought we were just going to keep going and reliving that over and over.
A 10 count of ace crushers and super kicks. So it's down to the final two. Henderson eliminated first, then Truex, and then Big Ben Johnson, and then Jekylls, and now it's Daniel Torch and Rick Luxury. He's looking for that cradle pile driver. Oh, he got it.
Wow.
Stuffed him with it.
Exclamation
point
on that.
One, two. Oh, Torch kicked out.
Gotta wonder if he would have hooked one leg if that wouldn't have been the end. And he's calling for it again.
Luxury is trying to putt Torch away again with that cradle pile driver. Flips over, jackknife. Two, three, got him!
And your winner by pinfall, Daniel Torch!
Daniel Torch with the victory. A very nice win over Rick Luxury. Oh, but Luxury, he's not happy. Force can fend for himself, though, another stunner. And Luxury gets sent out. And Daniel Torch is your winner. He's going to get his hand raised.
His partner, Virgil Flynn, wins the main event of the first show. Torch comes back, wins the main event of the second show. You got to wonder if these two are heading more on a collision course down the line.
So Daniel Torch is your winner. His PPW debut. We've seen a few very nice debuts for PPW this time around.
Big time.
And the main event winner.
This concludes our edition of Phoenix Pro Wrestling, live at the Phoenix Theater in Petaluma. Have a wonderful evening, happy early Easter, and we'll see you next time.